Bonjour, bonsoir Katie, j'espère que tu vas bien. Nous étions le dimanche 9 février hier, c'est la leçon 9 sur 33. Je suis malade tous les jours, every day. So we say 11 days in French, in English, it's a plural form, but in French it's, well, it's a plural form in French, but it's a single form in English. Tous les jours, je vais, so I go, I'm going to. Je vais manger chez moi. I'm going to eat at home, my place, at home. Je vais travailler. I'm going to work. Be careful because it's a verb and here it's a noun. Je vais au travail. Je vais au travail. Je vais au bureau. Je vais au bureau. Like the workplace, the office. Je dors. I sleep. So, je fais. It's always with an activity, any kind of activity. It can be a sport, can be work related. So, je fais du tennis. Je fais la cuisine. Okay. Je vais, je fais. Careful of the pronunciation. Je vais, je fais. Je fais les courses. Faire les courses is to go grocery shopping. Est-ce que tu fais les courses tous les jours? Do you go grocery shopping every day? Je ne fais pas. So that's a negative form. Est-ce que tu fais? Je fais en je ne fais pas. Les courses tous les jours. Est-ce que tu vas à la piscine tous les jours? Do you go to the swimming pool every day? Je ne vais pas à la piscine tous les jours. After we can work on once a week, twice a week, every Saturday, this kind of stuff. Est-ce que tu vas visiter la ville tous les jours? We're going to visit the city every day. So, il y a beaucoup de transports en commun. Actually, I made a mistake. Yes, transports en commun. Public transportation, commute system. But in fact, you don't use that. You take the car. Je prends la voiture pour aller en ville. So, okay. So, je prends la voiture pour aller en ville. I take the car to go to the city or to go downtown, au centre-ville. Qu'est-ce que tu fais tous les matins? What do you do? What are you doing? What do you do every morning? So, tous les matins, je prends un café, je prends un expresso, je prends un café au lait, un café noir. Tous les matins, je me brosse les dents, je prends une douche, je fais mon lit, je pars au travail à 10 h, I leave for work at 10. Tous les après-midi, every afternoon, so you can say whatever you want, hein. Je rentre chez moi, je vais au supermarché, je visite mes amis, etc. Je regarde la télé, je mange, je vais au restaurant. Tous les soirs, every evening, et toutes, it's a feminine form, toutes les nuits, every night, je dors. So now, let's think bigger. Toutes les semaines, every week, toutes les 2 semaines, every 2 weeks, tous les mois, so tous les mois, every month. We could say une fois par mois, once a month. Okay. Anyway, so we have the file, the bottom of this document. We're gonna go through that. So, the recent past, don't forget, hein, je viens de, you are currently doing something, je suis en train de, and you are about to do something, je suis sur le point de. Okay? So, je viens de terminer mon rapport, I just finished, mon travail, mon projet, je suis en train de regarder la télé, I'm currently watching TV, ou je suis sur le point de regarder la télé, I'm about to watch TV. Une date passée composée et l'imparfait ont the main past tenses. I sent you, I'm currently sending you like the new edition of Grammaire Progressive, the book we used with the passé composé, hein, to explain the passé composé. And so basically, passé composé has two verbs. J'ai mangé. We are tempted to translate I have eaten. But it's better to use a simple past. So, j'ai mangé, I ate. J'ai mangé un sandwich, I ate a sandwich. Je mangeais un sandwich. That we, you know, I don't like when the French translate the tenses because it's not always accurate. But I would say it's more like a past progressive. That means it's like I was eating. It's more narrative, descriptive, more emotional. So, je mangeais un sandwich, I was eating a sandwich. And you can specify where you were. How was the sandwich, you know, and you can describe the weather, etc., etc. So, passer les vacances is to spend the vacation. Spend the vacation. So that is, oui, j'ai emmené mes enfants. I brought the kids along. J'ai visité, I visited, etc., etc. Okay, so that is based on the document we're gonna go through. Est-ce que tu as déjà lu Victor Hugo? Have you already read Victor Hugo? Non, je n'ai pas déjà lu Victor Hugo. Read it already, so we can say je n'ai jamais lu Victor Hugo. I've never read Victor Hugo. Victor Hugo is Les Misérables. Misérable is the most common. There are others, but it's the most common. Est-ce que tu as déjà vu un film en français? Have you already seen a movie in French? Oui, j'ai déjà regardé un film en français. Lequel? Which one? And it's a masculine form. Laquelle? That means the same. Hein? Laquelle, lesquelles? Qui est laquelle is which one? It's a feminine form. Lesquelles? Which ones? Masculine pronom. Lesquelles? Which ones? Féminin pronom. So, Louis de Funès était un comédien très connu, très populaire en France. Est-ce que tu as déjà bu du vin? Already drunk wine? Had wine? Oui, bien sûr. Yes, of course. Okay. So now. So here to be, to have, to go, venir, to come, to do. Those are the different exercises we did. Okay, so let me just go to this page. It should work. There we go. So I'm gonna do that quickly. So here we're talking about être, la mère de Luc est maîtresse. Maîtresse, she's a teacher. Luc's mother. Je ne suis pas anglaise. I'm not British. Vous êtes très content aujourd'hui, so you're very happy today. Tu es mon meilleur ami, you're my best friend. Ces enfants sont très mignons. These kids are very cute. Marie est très sympathique. Marie is very kind, very nice. Nous sommes un peu tristes. We are a bit sad. Les parents de Luc sont canadiens. Sorry about the pixelization. Luke's parents are Canadian. Avoir. Okay, you have the, conjugated forms. J'ai un chien qui s'appelle Milou. I have a dog called Milou. Monique a une nouvelle voiture. So, I like that, hein. J'ai like that. Monique has a new car. Nous avons beaucoup de jouets. We have a lot of toys. On a une très belle maison. We have a very beautiful house. Monsieur, vous avez faim? Sir, are you hungry? Mes amis ont beaucoup de bijoux. My friends, female form, have a lot of jewelries. Ma grand-mère a mal aux jambes. My grandmother has, we can say her legs hurt. Le professeur et moi avons un stylo rouge. Teacher and I have a red pen. Allez, tu go. Julie va au cinéma tous les week-ends. Les étudiants ne vont pas à l'école pendant les vacances. Les étudiants ne vont pas à l'école pendant les vacances. They are not going to school during the vacation. Mon père et moi allons au centre de loisirs. Mathieu et Lucie vont à la piscine en été. Centre de loisirs is like YMCA places where you can practice different activities, sport activities. Mathieu et Lucie go to the swimming pool during the summer, en été. Christine et moi allons prendre un verre ce soir. Christine and I are going to take, to have a drink tonight. Tu vas au lycée Victor Hugo. Are you going to the high school, Victor Hugo High School? Madame, comment allez-vous? Ablez. How are you? Je vais au centre-ville à pied. I go downtown by foot, à pied. Venir is a new verb. Venir is to come. Je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient, on vient. Nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. Julien vient nous rendre visite cette semaine. Je viens d'arriver chez ma grand-mère. So, to pay a visit this week. I just arrived at my grandmother's place. Tu vas au théâtre avec nous? Are you going to the theater with us? Nous venons du centre commercial, which we come from the mall. Amandine et Marc venons du collège en vélo. Amandine et Marc, non, viennent, sorry, viennent, they come from the middle school by bicycle. On vient d'ouvrir la fenêtre, we just opened the window. Vous venez en Suisse avec vos enfants. You, it's like you come to Switzerland, it's like, or you go to Switzerland, oh my god, with your children. Le prof d'anglais vient des États-Unis, the English teacher comes from the United States. Okay, I need to turn down. I have a Chinese student. I sent her, some files concerning the coronavirus. Actually, there are different things here. I sent her, there's this guy, there are different videos of the police in China chaining families inside their homes. There's Miles Guo, says the government is lying about the number of deaths. Well, you have a lot of videos and a lot of people talking, and so you have a lot of witnesses. So it's, I sent this stuff to my friend, and she's just she's freaking out actually. So yeah, she's from Hong Kong as well. Anyways, so there is this guy here on YouTube. If you want, you can check the video. Miles Guo interview with Stephen K. Bannon on War Room Pandemic. So it's very interesting. His English is horrible, but you know, there is a translation here. Anyway, for the Chinese and for people who are trying to make sense of what he's saying. So, coming back, where was I? Here. Faire, to do, to make. Jacques fait de la natation. He's doing swimming, for he does swimming. So he swims, basically. Je fais du judo avec mon frère. I do aikido with my brother. Tu fais du tennis en hiver, du ski in winter. Nous faisons du canoë tous les étés, we do canoë every summer. On fait du théâtre à l'école, so we practice, we perform theater at school. Ma copine et moi, so us, we, faisons de la danse africaine, so we do African dance. Vous faisiez de l'escalade en Suisse, du climbing in Switzerland. Ma mère fait des travaux manuels. My mother does some manual work. It's like it's a DIY or home improvement, can be a lot of stuff, whatever manual stuff she does. So that is it. And now I'm going to send you another video concerning grammar. This one. Zoom in. Up. This is a new version. It's page 176. I sent you the transcript asking you to do the exercise on 176, exercise 1. Okay? So it's this one. Okay, you're gonna try. You try. And concerning the passé composé, well, basically, we are right now talking about to have present tense. J'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, on a. Nous avons, vous avez, ils ont, elles ont. Manger is a past participant. The verb ends with a er. We drop the er and we replace it with a. Okay, all er verbs. But the thing is, so, aujourd'hui, today, cette semaine, this week, ce mois-ci, this month, cette année, this year, hier, yesterday, la semaine dernière, last week, le mois dernier, last month, l'année dernière, last year. So, we have to have auxiliary verb, present tense plus past participle. So it's very easy, but the thing is we're going to have to study the past participle. And they're not always easy to remember. So lire, to read, voir, to see, boire, to drink, j'ai lu, j'ai vu, j'ai bu. Okay, majority will use to have. There is like a small list of verbs using to be. Okay? Like reflective verbs and stuff like that. So, entendre, attendre, répondre, perdre. To hear, to wait, to answer, to lose. Entendu, attendu, répondu, perdu. So, we'll continue the next time. Okay? Let's not do too much because it's very confusing otherwise. You have a nice week and I'll talk to you on Sunday next week. Take care.